Hey guys, subscribe for daily content. And if you're shopping for gear, make sure you check out the description for the newest items at some of the very best online retailers. There's also links for some of the items that I personally recommend. Thanks. What's going on YouTube? Metal Complex here, and today I've got another short little unboxing video to share with you guys. I know exactly what's in here because it was sent to me by Urban EDC Supply. To my knowledge, there is an open pre-order available for this knife. You guys can check it out. I'll link it right down in the description. You guys can check it out if you want to. They reached out to me and said, do you want to check this knife out? And I looked at it and said, yeah, that looks pretty neat. So I'm excited to get into it. I haven't handled it yet. I'm going to save that part for you guys. Thanks so much to my patrons for supporting me. Please make sure to follow me on Instagram at metal_complex. And thanks to Urban EDC Supply for sending this in for me to take a look at. I don't get to keep this. This will go back to them when I'm done. But I did want to check it out. It looked neat. So this is... Oh, we got two things? Yeah, okay. Hold on. So, yeah, that's exactly what these are. One of them's got a fancy clip. Awesome. So these are Urban EDC knives, right? Some of these are, you know, they work with different designers, right? And sometimes different OEMs, but these are Urban EDC Supply knives, which is cool. We don't see that exactly that same type of thing, you know, across the knife world. We have different designers working with OEMs, but I think it's important to note that for sure. So I think that might be the fancy one. These are little guys, but I thought they looked cool. Yeah, okay, so this is the Dutchman. Hold on. Yeah, okay, you know what? It's actually fairly easy to, hold on. Let's see if I can get this. I know I can get it. Yeah, that D10 is actually really nice for a little tiny chunky frame lock. See that? There we go. Yeah, look at this. you know, this kind of reminds me of, it's obviously not exactly the same thing, but it makes me think of my old Curtis ODT, which I really miss. I have a thing about little knives. You know, I always talk about my issue with pocket knives that I want to carry is I want to get a full grip. Unless they're so short that it's almost kind of a, it's fun because it's tiny kind of thing, right? And it's a bonus if they are still somewhat easy to manipulate. And I'm trying to figure out exactly where I want to put my fingers or if it's if it's easier to reverse flick. I can actually get it. I think it's probably, yeah, you can get it. This is more of a knife that I probably would prefer to open with two hands, but it's absolutely possible. So the materials here, we have micarta on this guy and then titanium, and I believe, yeah, these are M390. Look at that little grind. I mean, here's the thing. It's actually plenty utilitarian, right? I mean, this isn't gonna be a, it's not gonna be something that you would take out and do, you know, use for hard use or anything like that. I'm still trying to figure out how I wanna do this. But little draw cuts, and I mean, it's essentially a little utility, you know, like a little utility blade. But it's got enough of a tip that it'll, you know, it'll still poke holes and stuff. The edge is actually done really well. And so it got a little hollow grind on it. Yeah, I think it's actually fairly, I think it's actually pretty thin behind the edge. Hold on. It's not nearly as chunky behind the edge as I thought it was going to be. Actually, yeah, it slices extremely well. Yeah, well, hold on. Can I get the wavies? Yeah, a little bit. But as far as like your straight cuts, oh yeah, no problem. I mean, factory edge, right? Okay, I want to take a look at this other guy, and then I'm going to get measurements. This is the fancier one. Is this the full tie? Okay, yeah. So right off the bat, I like this one better. I like the weight on this guy just a little bit better. This is hand rub satin finish, mocha tie clip, and mocha tie spacer. Cool, obviously going to cost a little bit more. Both of them are plenty smooth, and the D10 is exactly the same on both. Gosh darn it. It actually, my issue here is figuring out where to get my hands so that they're, that's how I'm bracing on top of the pocket clip and so that I'm off the frame lock. But yeah, I think, I think I like this guy a little bit more. I want to take measurements here real quick so people can get an idea of how big these things are or how small they are. Not a review. This is not a review. Just unboxing, first impressions, right? Overall length, 5 1/8. Yeah. Blade length, 2 inches. Cutting edge, about 1.85. That's what we're looking at there. Between the two, as far as weight goes, where's the scale? There it is. So, the micarta guy first, 2.65 ounces. I bet this guy's 3.25. That's what I'm gonna guess. Almost, yeah, 3.35. Yeah. So, I mean, for something of this size, this guy's heavy. But again, I mean, it's 3.35 ounces. It's really not that much weight, right? This is a cool knife. It's a cool little knife, right? I mean, you know, I saw the price on it, I think, is okay, right? These base ones, I feel like it's okay. I mean, I'm glad the quality is what it is. That's what I was waiting for. I was like, well, as long as, you know, it feels like everything's, you know, in check, then I think we'll be all right. It's not going to be for everybody, though. I mean, I think that's pretty obvious. These are going to be for some people and not going to be for other people. But, you know, it's like, if you're going to do a little chunky premium knife, then you kind of have to get everything else right if you're going to ask the price that we're all expecting him to ask, right? This guy's going to be a lot more expensive. I hope they offer a plain, I feel like they probably offer a plain tie version of it without the mocha tie, right? That's what I'd go for. The micarta ones are fine if you're trying to like balance out the weight or this or that, but if they offer a full titanium one without the mocha tie clip, I think that's where you're going to get the best bang for your buck. If you want the special version with the special materials, right, then great. But yeah, this is neat. I'll probably still do a full video on this. This is an interesting little knife, but it's one of those where there's obviously more utilitarian thing. I mean, there's always, it doesn't matter what we're looking at, there's always going to be stuff out there that's more utilitarian. It makes more sense dollar for dollar when you're going to use it. But the people who are going to look at stuff like this and buy stuff like this are going to buy it because they like the fact that it is kind of a weird little chunky knife, right? Not because they believe that you can get something, like that you can't get something better for the money. No, that's not why people are going to look at these. And, you know, for that reason, it's completely and totally understandable, right? I mean, buy what you like for the reasons that you want to. But yeah, it's like I was saying, if you're going to do a little knife, darn, that is the only issue I have with this, is trying to figure out where to brace, because it's like, I can't hold on to enough of the knife and keep it from flying out of my hands. But then again, trying to grip it completely inevitably lands my finger on that, you almost have to like hold onto it up here. There we go. Yeah, it's just weird. Truthfully, it's probably easier to do the reverse flick on it than anything else. But it's plenty easy to disengage, right? It's just, the handle is so short. It's really hard to find a way to hang on to it. These are neat. These are different, right? I like looking at different stuff. I see a lot of the same stuff over and over and over again. And these are different enough that it makes it interesting, right? I think that's going to be pretty much it. There we go. You almost have to put your index finger higher up in the knife. I'll do a full review on these a couple of weeks down the road. Thanks again to Urban EDC Supply for sending them in. Like I said, link right down in the description if you guys want to check them out. Please make sure to follow me on Instagram at metal_complex. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like. If you'd like to check out my other content, I do, of course, have lots of videos of knives that are either expensive or inexpensive that I do or don't like, so check those out. And if you enjoy all my content, go ahead and click on that Metal Complex logo right there and subscribe, because there's definitely more coming. Thanks again for watching, everybody, and have a great day.